Chapter 15, The Finals, Game 2, A Pretty Ugly Win. The only gripe that I had about Game 1 was that the C's defense was lethargic at the start, but that wasn't a problem in Game 2. The Celtics put it on the Lakers. At one point, the C's were up by 24 points. As I mentioned in my podcast, Game 2, A Pretty Ugly Win, I relaxed and went to fix a snack. Apparently, I wasn't the only one that relaxed. But when I came back to my tube, the Lakers had cut the lead to 2. I couldn't believe that miss. I thought surely there was some type of technical error on the scorekeeper's part. How in the hey did the C's let the Lakers come all the way back? Enter Leon Poe, straight to the rescue. Lord have mercy, I was so happy to see him do his thing. With 21 points in 15 minutes, Mr. Poe was ballin'. Yet I was even more proud of him after watching a halftime feature on how he honored his deceased mother, Connie Landry, with his life. Leon took care of his siblings through the hard times like any nobleman would. His story struck home with me because I knew what it was like to be homeless. I knew about hunger cramps and the intense responsibility one feels for the life of a young child or sibling. I was so very happy to see how Miss Landry's little man rose up to become a world champion. Kudos to Leon. Rajon Rondo's 16 dimes / assist also made the highlight film for that game. My only knock against Rondo was that he needed to attack. In my podcast, I tried to encourage him to shoot the ball because even if he missed the shot, his aggression would have kept LA's defense honest. Sometimes the best defense is an attacking offense. When a player constantly attacks, he tires his defender out. For example, most old school viewers understood that Rip Hamilton's kinetic style of play affected Ray Allen's shot in the Detroit series. Rip ran Ray ragged around picks, screens, and curls. Doc wisely flipped the script on the Lakers and challenged Kobe to stay with Ray Allen the way Ray stayed with Rip. That move proved too much for the Lakers star as Bryant's offense was rendered ineffective in Game 1 and part of Game 2. Coach Jackson wisely put Kobe on a passive Rajon Rondo, and that worked very well until Game 6. Note, my podcast Game 2, A Pretty Ugly Win, explained why the Celtics were the best team. For unlike San Antonio, the Phoenix Suns, and even the Lakers, the C's won this big game despite losing a large lead.